So I think the universal response to that is your first statement would be by answering the question either yes, no, or it depends. Answer it categorically first, you know, so that the checker or the examiner would know what's your position on the matter. Then after that, you can cite the applicable law or jurisprudence and then explain your answer. But the most important part is be concise. I don't think a checker would appreciate reading four paragraphs when you can put it in one, especially with the bar having a time limit. You have to maximize your time.
There's already a universal formula for this, with the direct answer, the legal basis, and your analysis. That's like Sir JM said, we have to be concise. We have to take into account that the checker will only give like 30 seconds to 1 minute to your answer due to the volume of bar takers. No? So you have to really send the point the most efficient way you can.
With regard to the citation of laws, actually, we're not expected to cite the law verbatim, but as much as possible, use the legal terminologies, the way how it is used in the law, as it would show mastery and familiarity with the law that you're talking about.
The tip is that you should answer the question within the first sentence. So, ang ginagawa ko is that yung first sentence mo pa lang, isama mo na yung basis at conclusion. I-compress mo na siya. One example is, okay, I think everyone's familiar naman with the close now, here later doctrine of the banking laws. Ano? So instead of answering that no, the contention of one is correct, we can say that no, the contention of one is correct because under the close now, here later doctrine, the BSP can place a bank under receivership without prior notice. The goal here is to show to the examiner na alam mo na yung law, alam mo na yung issue, parang nilalatag mo na una pa. So that the examiner will appreciate it immediately. Magkakaroon siya ngayon ng presumption na yung second paragraph mo and third paragraph mo will definitely point to the right direction. Si scheme na lang niya. And with that, lalo na if correct yung answer mo, the examiner will most likely give you a high score, possibly the full 5 points.
I just like to say na parang unless you're 100% sure of the exact law, the exact case, or the exact, you know, provision, no, don't cite it. You can always say under the law or under the civil code if you're sure it's from the civil code. If it's a case, you can say as held by the Supreme Court or in a case decided by the Supreme Court. Even if your answer is correct, the doctrine is correct, but then you cited a wrong case or a wrong law, di ba? Then sayang yung full points that you would have otherwise gotten.
Sa akin una, you really have to read and understand the question first. Sometimes, sa sobrang excited mo sumagot, sinusulat mo na agad yung sagot mo nang hindi mo naiintindihan yung question. Mm-hmm. Also, I had a lot of professors which were previous bar examiners, and sobrang pet peeve nila yung grammar kapag mali. So, always check the subject-verb agreement.
Another pitfall is volunteering an answer to a question that is not being asked. We think that we might make a good impression if we make our answer longer. This is especially true if you're trying to make up because you don't know the answer to the main issue. Like, for example, in criminal law, the question is whether or not the crime of estafa by post-dating a check is committed. As we know, estafa by post-dating is a crime that is a bit related or similar to BP 22. Now, what if the student or the bar taker doesn't really know much about estafa by post-dating? Now, he might be tempted to, or he or she might be tempted to veer away from estafa and move the discussion to BP 22. Like, for example, the bar examinee will answer this way. No, the crime of estafa by post-dating is not committed because the crime that was committed is BP 22. So that's an improper way of addressing that question because you are deflecting from the issue.
I first tried to read all the questions. Now, for the questions that I'm familiar of, I tried answering them first.
No matter how much time you devote to that question, most likely mababa lang yung score mo. That time will be better spent dun sa mga questions na you're familiar with.